So I will talk about network plasticity and the information infection trade-off in primate societies. We know that group living brings advantages but also inconveniences. For instance, individuals who are the most central in social networks have a higher probability of getting and spreading information but also infection. So informed individuals are seen as valuable interacting partners, whereas infected individuals are avoided by others. This change in individual status leads to different patterns of social interaction. And this change in social relationship leads to structural change at the network level that affects social transmission, which affects individual status. We propose a framework that integrates two mechanisms simultaneously, examining information and pathogen flow as explicit and opposite entities with emergent patterns of social networks reflecting a trade-off between them. We exemplify this trade-off through a survival indicator. We show that network efficiency and modularity, for instance, in empirical networks, are higher than the one in theoretical networks. We also show that species tree as neocortex ratio are linked to network properties in primate societies, as here with efficiency. This indicates that evolutionary processes are involved in the selection of some network topologies, and this leads to the concept of adaptive networks or network plasticity. To go further, we propose to do some field experiments and some modeling to modify the information infection probability to assess the network adaptivity. Thank you very much for your attention.